Time now for an update from Fox Carolina News and Fox Carolina Weather. Weather rates certified most accurate.
Good evening, I'm Cody Alcorn. We're following breaking news at this hour. It's out of Spartanburg County. That's where the sheriff's office is investigating back-to-back armed robberies. Now, what I can tell you is the first one happened on Fair Forest Road at the subway there, and just a couple of minutes later, a second robbery at the Valero on Chesney Highway at Cleveland Chapel Road was robbed. This follows a string of robberies from last week in Greer, Spartanburg City, and Spartanburg County. We are working to get more information, of course. We'll update you at foxcarolina.com. And speaking of foxcarolina.com, a couple of the headlines we're following this evening. The city of Greenville extends their mask ordinance. That is one thing we're also following out of Spartanburg County, where the Spartanburg City Council also voted to have a mask ordinance as well. We have the very latest on that at our website. And we're also following, of course, we have the Electoral College that cast their votes today across the country. All 50 states have cast their votes. Those will go on to Congress later in January, the 1st of January. We've also learned that Attorney General William Barr resigning. His last day with the White House will be on the 23rd of December. And a couple other big headlines we're following as well. Georgia to audit one of their county's signature on ballot envelopes, talking about that signature that's been a huge issue down there in the Peach State. And of course, you can stay with FoxCarolina.com throughout the night and our free Fox Carolina News app for continuing coverage. Right now, we do want to check in with Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kent.
Cody, we're looking at a cold night ahead with temperatures in the low 30s across the upstate to start Tuesday morning. 31 degrees, in fact, for areas like Greenville, Spartanburg, and Anderson. In the mountains, mid-20s expected, and it will be breezy at times. It's going to make it feel even colder. Now, throughout the day, it's not going to warm up all that much. We're only going to get into the 40s, and then there'll be a quick drop in temperatures as we go into tomorrow night, and that's when we could see some freezing rain, especially early Wednesday morning. A slight chance, especially along the 85 corridor and north, but the best chance of any kind of accumulation of ice is going to be up in western North Carolina, so it could make for some dicey roads Wednesday morning before around 10 a.m. Of course, you'll want to check in on the morning news as well as at 4, 5, 6, 10, and 11 for the latest.